Hello, in this video tutorial I will show you quickly how you can build your own sculpt images. If the archives which are required are already built by someone. For example, when Gnode releases a new version of the framework, the packages are typically already provided to you so that you can build your sculpt images by your own. So let's go first to the web page of Gnode. We will first look for the latest version of the sculpt release, which is from July, but the actual framework release is from .11. And if you want to have a sculpt based on the latest framework, you can build it your own. And that I'm now going to describe. So let's first go to the latest sculpt release. There, let's have a look for the documentation page, which is down here. And when you scroll a bit down to the advanced usage section, there's some subsection telling you how to build the boot images yourself. And this will use as starting point. So first, you will have to follow the instruction provided here, which mainly means you have to download the Gnode toolchain. And just for the sake of completeness, just that you find the toolchain quickly, go to the download page of the Gnode homepage, and there's a toolchain part which describes how to download the toolchain or how to compile it by yourself. So if you have done this, then you can actually go to the first step and clone the Git repository. So we need some shell. We will make it a bit larger and it should always stay in front. So then we will use this command to clone the source code, which may take some time. Here we go, we have now the source code. Now we can go to the next step. We let out this and this step and we'll direct straightforward go to the creating the build directory. So first we go into the Gnode repository and create the build directory. And as you now see, we have a build directory and specifically for 64 bits on x86. And the next step is saying that we should enable some repositories, some source code repository, which we will need. Okay, so let's do it. Go into the build configuration and let's have a look for the libports directory as set by the documentation. Enable it. And we need the ports repository, the DDE Linux repository, GEMS, and also the IPXE repository. And the next step is also important, that you change the image which is generated from ISO, which is default to a disk image. So let's look for ISO and change it to a disk version. So now we have adjusted our build configuration. And just to make sure that we are actually running we will build a newer version of Sculpt, you can look for the version file, which will tell you which version Sculpt image will be. It will be based on the November version, which is the latest we currently provide. So, okay, now we are prepared. The next step is we just will try to build actually the sculpt image by using the right make instruction. So we will invoke it and now The Makefile will complain that the archives you need for building Skype are missing, which are named here. And we will now try to just to download it because which each framework release they are typically provided. So we will just say we want to download it. We use this specific version and this specific Nova version. And then we can start. And the other option before I forgot it, you can of course try to build this from source all the packages. But this will take some time, so we just will download it. It will be quicker for the moment. Let's go ahead. And now, yeah, depending on your internet connection, it may take a while. Okay, now we got downloaded all the ready built archives we need for building the Skype image. Now we can try to do the actual build command again. And as you see, it complains again. And the issue is that we actually need ready to use grub bootloader. The nice thing is, GNOME provides this already, so you just have to download the already built grub bootloader by preparing the port as told by the make message. So let's download it. This was quicker, and now let's try to build the image again. Okay, this looks good. The image should be available in this folder, also as told in the documentation. So let's have a look in the build directory. The specific run script created this image. Indeed. So now we can go to the last step, actually copying it to some USB stick. So I will use this one. Just attach it to the machine. As said, here we have to find out which device name it actually got assigned. So let's have a look in the kernel log, and here you see that the stick got the name SDB. So that means we can take this command, replace this with a name and issue the operation. Then I need to provide a password of my machine and finally the stick got created. So now we can go ahead and boot the Skype image. Thank you for watching this video.